Welcome to ARC Automation Studio. My name is Fabian Banke and I will be your host today to discuss the industrial additive manufacturing market. I invited my colleague Will Hastings, who just recently published a report about a worldwide industrial additive manufacturing market. Hi Will, it's a pleasure having you here today. And let me start directly with the first question. Can you give a short introduction to the audience and explain a bit what is your area of expertise within ARC and how this has enriched your analysis of the market? And directly a second question, what are some of the hottest topics about industrial additive manufacturing? Please let us know.
Aside from additive manufacturing, my focus at ARC is in the product lifecycle management software space, which is interesting when speaking about additive manufacturing, because much of the software used for designing additive parts and validating additive processes come from these PLM suppliers. So aside from that, I like to look at the additive manufacturing market from the perspective of these five pillars: systems, material, software, supply chain, and knowledge. And looking at any one of these, there are certainly hot topics that can be discussed, whether it's increased throughput and build space and systems, completely new technology that's coming into the market, growth in material availability, online marketplaces in the supply chain, introduction of standards, more consulting firms for additive manufacturing coming to the market. It's still a very young technology, a very young market. So there are, in fact, a lot of hot topics and certainly a lot of things to discuss.
Thanks, Will. Can you please share also with us the major trends you discovered in industrial additive manufacturing?
The first major trend is the cooperation of stakeholders within the additive manufacturing ecosystem. At this point, the market is large enough to support strong partnerships among these stakeholders, which is beginning to generate significant value for them. Well-executed partnerships provide benefits to end users, which further encourages market growth. So this is the beginning of a pretty significant feedback loop within the market. The second trend is the continued development of powerful simulation tools used for designing parts and validating processes. This is a result of the partnership between PLM companies and additive manufacturing system providers. In some respects, these tools help to legitimize additive manufacturing from an engineering perspective. The last trend is in design for additive manufacturing. Engineers are learning how to exploit additive technology beyond relatively simple processes, such as lightweighting, and are starting to focus on designs at the system level. So this includes combining multi-component assemblies and creating novel functionality using additive manufacturing systems.
All right, Will. Thank you for sharing with us your knowledge. And due to the fact that additive manufacturing is really a hype subject all over the world, what are the current underlying drivers that have been critical to additional growth in the market?
To start, there are essentially three main applications for industrial additive manufacturing. In order of popularity, they are prototyping, tool fabrication, and production manufacturing. The drivers that I've highlighted here, growth in material options, technology options, and research and development, help to expand the addressable market for each application and increase the viability where they are already being applied. The growing library of material options, for example, is enabling the creation of prototypes with characteristics that more closely match the intended end product. New materials also enable the manufacturing of production parts that previously required conventional manufacturing. The commercialization of new technologies and systems are also fundamental to the growth of the market. There are unique pros and cons of each vendor's technology, and so an additive application that is non-viable using a certain system may be competitive on another. The influx of new technology and new systems into the market provides end users an opportunity to find a machine that possesses the necessary combination of cost, material selection, build time, and other characteristics to address their needs. Last but not least, research and development in the area of additive manufacturing is essential to the growth of the industry. The technologies represented here are very young compared to conventional manufacturing technologies. So every bit of new knowledge helps to ensure a more controlled, predictable process, which is to be expected of an industrial process.
Compared to conventional manufacturing technologies like drilling, milling, and so on, additive manufacturing is still a niche market. Well, what are the primary hurdles restricting additive manufacturing from moving behind its niche?
Compared to conventional technologies, additive manufacturing is still a niche market. In order to scale and reach a far wider audience, additive manufacturing stakeholders need to address the characteristics that are universal to conventional manufacturing technologies but lacking in additive. Conventional manufacturing technologies are highly standardized, they're well controlled, and for the most part are able to be automated and integrated into larger manufacturing processes. Additive manufacturing, on the other hand, lacks comprehensive standards for important aspects such as raw material, process control, operating parameters, and quality. Many additive technologies are also highly stochastic, that is to say, the number of input variables and the lack of precise knowledge of their effects often leads to unpredictable outcomes in final part geometry and material characteristics. With standards and continued R&D, these processes can become more predictable, reliable, and repeatable. And finally, increased automation, especially in part handling for post-processing, is necessary for integrating additive manufacturing into conventional manufacturing lines.
Thank you, Will, for sharing those interesting insights about the industrial AM market. If the audience like to get more information about the industrial additive manufacturing market, do not hesitate to contact the author, myself, or one of your client manager at ARC. Thank you for listening.